color is the wind, Daddy? Is it yellow, red or blue? When he's playing with my hair, Daddy, does he do the same to you? When he's dying, does his color fade? Is it gentle breeze, a lighter shade? Just like his friend, the sea, the wind feels blue to me. When the blackbird starts to sing, Daddy, do the flowers hear him too? When he's pouring out his heart, Daddy, tell me, what do roses do? Do they cast their scent upon the air? And this fragrance, just a rose in prayer, giving thanks to God above for the blackbird's song of love. Blow, wind, blow, wild and free. My daddy says you're a lot like me. I know each color, its shape and size. I've seen them all with my daddy's eyes. I know that grass is green, Daddy. I've touched it with my toes. And snow is purest white, Daddy. I've felt it with my nose. But my favorite color has to be the color of your love for me. And Daddy, I've been told that love is always gold. Wild and free. My daddy says you're a lot like me. My daddy says you're a lot like me. What color is the
sunshine, sunshine reggae. lean on. I just might have a problem that you understand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother.
Dear parents, I went to you especially 7 years ago when your child was baptized. You were given a light candle and entrusted with the responsibility of keeping the light of faith alive in your child's life. Over the years, you have kept that flame burning indeed. The good work you have been doing is bearing fruit in a beautiful and wonderful way here today. So I now call upon the chosen bearers to come forward and light the candle from the past.
Jesus Christ.
our Lord, pray for us. You sit on the
Oh.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. People were bringing little children to Jesus for him to touch them. The disciples turned them away. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them. For it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. I tell you solemnly, anyone who does not welcome the kingdom of God like a little child will never enter. Anyone who welcomes one of these little children in my name welcomes me. Anyone who scandalizes one of these little children that believes in me, it would be better that he will fall into the sea with a great windstorm around him. Then he put his arms around them, laid his hands on them, and gave them his blessing." And this is the gospel of the Lord.
We can't do that in one way and yet
and as real as he came into that stable in Bethlehem. And he'd be really present with you, and you can talk to him and thank him and tell him how much you love him. Now, I know that we are all worked up and prepared for this big day, and it's going to mean so much to us. But I want you to remember that every time that you come to Holy Communion is just as important as this first time. There is always the danger, yes, tomorrow, please God, we'll give communion, and it will be another special day. And after that, our special clothes on, our special box on, whatever. And next Sunday, there will be another special day. When we give the procession as a sacrament, there will be another special day for us. They have to come by you. We get into the habit of going to Holy Communion. And we can take it for granted. We can take Jesus for granted. Just as we take so many things for granted. And sometimes we can go just because it's routine. Just because that's what we're doing, we send up with our mass, we go up to the altar, and we come down again. And Jesus is really forgotten about. Wouldn't that be terrible? And yet you know that you can see some of the bigger boys and girls, they go for communion and they go back and sit down and they're looking around and they're not paying attention. How would it be awful if that happened to you? I was just reading last night about a certain father who was in Germany, long way from here. And when his son, actually for two of them, when they made their first commitment, he gave them two little trees to plant out of the yard. And he wanted them to plant those trees so that every time they looked at that tree, they'd remember their first commitment. And they would see that tree grow and grow and grow. And he wanted them to realize that their love for Jesus should also grow just as that tree was growing. And he did. And one of those young boys, he became a priest. And then he became a bishop in a place like all Munster, but not the Norse the same. He became a bishop of Munster in Germany. And at that time, a man named Hitler, how many of us have heard of Hitler? No, he was a bit more of a but it was 50 years ago, we celebrated just this year, we celebrated the end of the big world war. But Hitler was a tyrant. And Hitler wanted to get rid of all the little boys and girls who were born with any kind of deformity, mental or physical. And all people were no longer in use and were suffering from senile decay. He wanted to get rid of them. Now Jesus loves every boy and girl. Just as much as he loves you. Even though they have some kind of deformity, maybe negative, immoral, whatever. And he did not want that to happen. And this young boy, who had not become a bishop, and whose love for Jesus had grown and grown and grown, he stood up and he spoke out. And he knew, of course, he was in danger of being executed. But strange to say, Hitler was afraid to touch him. And in point of fact, he goes from where about 50,000 or 60,000 children to death. He stopped. And even though they thought he put millions to death, he did the wrong fight. Just because this little boy knew what Jesus coming to him in that every time that you cross that altar to receive Jesus and God in you, that you too will be growing in love for Jesus, and that he will see you more and more to you by each of them. And just a word to the parents now for we're not the morning, but anyway, it's a special day for you too, of course. You have watched your children grow, take their first steps, said their first few words. You've seen them go up their first day in school, and now you see them take another step. And it is, of course, very special day for you. God has given you a great privilege, a sharing in his creative power. It is also a terrifying responsibility. And of course the gospel reminds us of that too. The gentle Jesus gave to those who might put a stumbling block in the way of the children and gave them a terribly serious one. In this day and age, I'm afraid that warning seems to have gotten needed so many times. It is a terrible responsibility, but on the other hand, never forget that you're not carrying that in your own, that he is with you. He reminded us that there are the angels see the face of his heavenly Father. So he has a special angel guardian looking after each child. We have Christ's word for that. And if you're very afraid, there are times when you see it. That's of course if God has a place in your home. And that is so important today to give God a place in your home. There is time for him in prayer. There is time for him in the decoration of your home. He is the incompetent visitor in every home. So today, then, we congratulate you, we thank you for all you've done for your children, and we pray God's blessing on you. And as of course, it is also a special day for the teachers who now see their work coming to fruition. We thank them too on your behalf and behalf of the parish for the work they're doing for God. They are spreading God's kingdom in a very special and practical way. And so, to conclude, this is a very special day for all of us as we see another generation coming to the altar of God to give praise and thanks to him for his love for us. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now we have our prayers.
God, our Father, you have given us your word, that you will not be far from those who call upon you in prayer. In faith and hope and love, we ask you to graciously hear us now.
We pray. Remember the dead in our children who are making their first call here today. We want you loved us, and gave you so much for us, long years. We pray for our priests, teachers, and leaders of our parish. We thank the Lord for giving us good examples and helping us to be better and more caring young followers of Jesus, the Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
from your loving hands we will receive the Son, the most precious gift of heaven and earth, the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ. Blessed are you, God our Father, and all the people, and all the people who are here today. And may all our prayers of Jesus Christ call upon us. May all these things be lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord. We thank you, Lord, for this beautiful in the world, and for the happiness you have given us. We praise you for day and night, and for your new word which lights on our minds. We praise you for the earth and all people in it, and for all life which comes from people. We know that you are good, you love us, and you bring things for us. And so we say together, Holy, 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 God of our life.
Through him, with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit,
protect us from all anxiety as we wait for our hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said your apostles that in your peace, my peace I give you. Look down on our sins and the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your people, where you live forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us ask the Lord. Thank you.
starry summer night or a snow-covered winter's day. Sing it, children. But the love that lives within. Thank you.
Everybody needs a little help sometime. No one stands alone. Makes no difference if you're just a child like me or a king upon a throne. For there are no exceptions. We all stand in the line. Everybody needs a friend. Let me tell you of mine. He's my forever friend. My leave me never friend. From darkest night to rainbow's end, he's my forever friend. Even when I turn away, he cares for me. His love no one can shake. Even as I walk away, he's by my side. With every breath I take. And sometimes I forget. My halo fails to shine. Sometimes I'm not his friend, but he is always mine. He's my forever friend. My leave me never friend. Darkest night to rainbow's end, he's my forever friend. If you still don't know the one I'm talking of, I think it's time you knew. Long ago and far away, upon cross, my friend died for you. So if you'd like to meet him and don't know what to do, ask my friend into your heart and he'll be your friend too. My forever friend, my leave me never friend. From darkest night to rainbow's end, he's my forever friend. He's my forever friend.